Welcome to the live stream of the Boerma Institute. My name is Jacqueline Boerma and I'm going to give the live stream today. Yeah. Welcome everybody. I hope you will enjoy the demo. So good morning, good afternoon, good evening, for wherever you are, welcome. I'm using a very nice, beautiful Leonotis. And it looks a little bit like the Irish bells, like the Molucella with flowers on. I'm going to make a kind of garden, like a little bit hilly. This weekend I was in the south of Holland with my aunts, so I enjoyed the scenery over there. And I'm going to make a little bit like that. So I'm using some Leonotis into the height, and that's probably my highest point somewhere. Trying to cut the Leonotis so I don't see the opening of the cut. And I'm going to use some very nice hydrangea. And the hydrangea will come somewhere at the base. I used some stones. I bought them at the garden center. So I picked them out one by one. And I'm using the Oasis biodegradable. So it's brown, so I don't need to cover everything. I have also some hollow stem flowers. So I hope I don't damage them. I could make a hole first, like I do with the Gerbera. That's possible too. These are zinnias and they're from my garden here at the school. So they're still blooming.
Why would you make a hole before?
Because the stem is hollow. I make a hole before because the stem is hollow, so I don't damage the flower that much. I think I said that, but maybe you didn't hear me. That sometimes happens with our students too. I have also some nice houtinia. Yep. And they kind of smelly. What was the English word again? Like something with fish?
Fish leaves.
Fish leaves? Mm,
yes.
So yes, they do. They smell a bit fishy. Or is that a different term in English? So, but the color is nice. They are autumn colors, although they have them the whole year round. Everything when it's new, it comes in the white and red and green. So that's very lovely to go with these colors because the colors will be mixed. I use them from pink to orange. I'm going to group them. Oh yeah. Yes. Angelica, you have a question or some news?
Well, not a question yet, but a lot of people in the chat are already saying hello. We have Anita de Vries.
Hi, Anita.
We have Joyce Shabby Chic saying ready to join.
Thank you very much for joining.
We have Sally Hardy saying hello, everyone, from Berkshire, UK. Great to be here.
Hello.
We have Angela Hurt saying afternoon, Jacqueline, Angelica, Mike, etc. Kisses.
Hi, Angela. So nice for you to join us again. Thank you very much.
And we have Hori Erueti, sorry for my pronunciation. Yay, I caught another life. Thank you.
Thank you very much for joining. It's lovely that you all are looking. I'm using some sedum. And some sedum, that's the dark red next to the orange. So the color is a nice different one. And they actually also come from our garden. So it's more, well, it's a garden arrangement, but it's not completely a Dutch garden arrangement. As we call it here in the school. So then the heights will be a little bit higher than we do now, than I do now. I also have used some heather, and I have used also a sedum. So it's this is a low plant, and I use the plant with the soil. So the soil is mixed together with the oasis. And actually, it almost can be an arrangement that will dry by itself, I think. I hope this does not make too much noise. Yeah.
So, Jacqueline, you're going to be jealous of this one. Sally Gilchrist says, hello from sunny Western Australia. Ooh. Sunny Australia.
Yes, sunny.
I want to go there.
Yeah, me too. We have had a very rainy summer. And also now we have really autumn weather. So that means rain and storm. It's not very beautiful outside. Last weekend it was all right. We walked in the hills of South Limburg, where my family comes from. So I walked with my aunt, well, actually one aunt, in the park and the hills for about 8 kilometers. And then it was nice weather. And after that, of course, we had a little bit to drink and visited the other aunts. So I'm grouping this next to the stones. So it will be a little bit like hilly. I think I forgot the carnations, but maybe they have gone already. That's possible. Yep.
We have Supri Creativity Wayono saying, a container is so beautiful. I'm happy to see you again.
Thank you very much. Thank you also for the compliments. The container is, I think, it's also very nice. Last year with Christmas, I made a live stream with it. And for that occasion, we spray painted it gold. Before that, it was aluminium color. So it changed color. Remember, Angelica?
No.
No?
I thought it was always gold.
No. Oh. Let's see, some nice dark hydrangea. You hear probably the noise a little bit. It is already drying. But I thought it would be a nice color to go inside the container. And some... Oops, that was a dahlia. These are also nice and orangey. I need some orange color, some more at the base. So I'm going to fill a little bit with these. Carthamus. And the carthamus has a nice fluffy head with some peaceful green at the base. So very convenient to use on top of the oasis.
So Jacqueline, mm-hmm. Angela says that she loves the ginkgo necklace.
Oh yes, thank you very much. Me too. When were we in Japan when I bought that?
2015.
Oh, something like that. And it was handmade, and the artist didn't want to say how he made it, but I loved it. I had to have it, and I only wear it like Japanese people with the ginkgo leaves. They only wear it in autumn. So whenever the ginkgo is golden, then they wear and they eat things like that. And also like the pottery or the hoe heet dat dingen? The containers, the plates where you eat from. There when it has so gone. When it is autumn, then you can use something with ginkgo. Not in springtime, of course. Yeah, when you hear somebody coughing at the background, then it's Angelica. Just warning.
It's me dying a bit. I got a mean cold.
It has nothing to do with the thing that is going around at this moment, but it's just a cold.
Just a regular old cold.
Simple cold. We are still able to have that too. Let's continue. Some roses. I also group that. And then continue on the other side. No, I don't like that space there. Probably more here. And then so I don't have to, I put them deep on top of the oasis, so I don't have to use anything else there, because I want to keep everything vertical. And then maybe just a group here next to the dark of the hydrangea. You probably can't see the whole arrangement. Maybe I can tip it over without losing my stones. Oh, you're having the second camera. So maybe if you watch the edit version, you can also see it. Well, the container is very heavy. I don't want to, don't want to spoil any water. Then I also have some very nice, still have one zinnia left. So what do I do with it? Maybe just here in the depths there. I have some, questions?
Well, no, just Step Boy Sweden saying hello from lovely sunny Sweden.
Oh, and sunny also.
I think it's Jimmy England from Still Floor Sterna. Saying it looks great, your arrangement.
Thank you very much, Jimmy. Nice that you are looking also, watching sunny Sweden. Seems to be sunny everywhere except for Holland.
We're in the wrong location.
Heb ik al gezegd?
And we have a question from Angela.
Yes.
Are you using Oasis Biodegradable?
Yes, I'm using Oasis Biodegradable. Very convenient brown stuff. And it's also matching the stones. So when it's a little bit dark from here, probably a lot of light from there. But when I don't cover it completely, I don't mind that it is still a little bit visible. But it works like the green one, very easy to put in. Only better for nature. And Oasis has a new product. But I don't have that here yet. Well, I have it in the school, but not in such a big amount.
So, Jacqueline, we're not the only one with heavy rain, because Angela has floods in the UK.
Oh, wow. So that's very bad. We don't have them here at this moment yet. Well, I should sharpen my knife, probably. But when it keeps raining like that, we probably get the water from Germany again. I use some conifer over here too, so I have more or less a triangle with the nice woolly green. We also will use that for Christmas. Then I have some very beautiful moss. I step out of the thing again. Yeah. some nice green bulb moss, which is very convenient. I wired this one, haven't wired the other ones yet. Yeah, go ahead, Antiranka.
Yes, question from Angela. Have you tried agra wool yet?
Yes, we have. Yes, we have. We have tested it last year, I think. Or before, you know, you wouldn't, you know what. But it was not, it was okay. But I didn't prefer the Oasis compared to the agra wool.
And the agra wool has volcanic rock.
Yeah, so.
The
agra wool has volcanic rock, so it's not that. It has a residue also, so. Well, I prefer Oasis. Mike, maybe. Be able to tell you more about that.
Actually, we're going to do a little video on it in the future.
Yeah, so Mike will do a little video about the difference between the agra wool, the Oasis biodegradable, and also the new product. Yeah, go ahead.
A question from Supri Creativity Wayono. Is it possible for the cameraman to be closer to the container because I can't see the arrangement clearly?
No, we can only do that in the edit.
So we can only show you in the edited version the arrangement clearly and from other sides and from above.
Let's
so
see here.
That's the second
can
camera.
Can I do that? Can you see that?
Yeah, this is good.
This.
Not me, not me. Yeah? Can you see it clearly? Oops. So, where did I leave my moss?
So, here Angela also says she was not impressed with the agra wool.
Yeah. Well, of course, I understand that you want to try something different. It's better for nature, they say. But yeah, we'll see what the future brings. Some nice, I wired it. Again, the moss, because it stays closer together. So I think most of our students think this is the most difficult thing to do. You hold the moss upside down, put a wire around it, not too high, not too low. And then I twist the moss, because when I twist the moss, it gets very tight. And when I turn the wires, it's not that tight.
We can do a little video for the patrons, maybe.
Yes, that's a good thing. But I think most of the patrons have been to the school, so they know. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Mike is saying we could do a little video for the patrons for about wiring the moss, so we can show it clearly. Yep.
Jimmy is sending you like the strong arm emoticons because you lifted the the arrangement.
It is very heavy.
And Supri says, thank you for the inzooming of the camera. And we have Ionella Poggio saying, hello, so glad to see you.
Hi, nice that you are watching again. Thank you.
And Angela says, stunning.
Thank you very much. You mean me, of course.
And we have Shaida Guman saying, goedemiddag allemaal. Prachtig arrangement. Mooi hoor, Jacqueline.
Dankjewel, Shaida. Dankjewel. So I'm just finishing with a little bit of moss, some extra moss, and getting it under my nails. Oh, now, no, I cannot stop yet. What I forgot almost, I have some lovely dahlias, so still need to use some of those. Whoa. But where do Doorzoeken. Yeah, Mike was saying we are missing Japan. Yeah, we are missing Japan a lot. Wish we could go there again. Soon, hopefully. Maybe here. I can place some of these lovely dahlias. Oh, wow. Oh, my God. Well, hello. I see myself because there's a big screen behind, so behind the camera. So you got me scared, Mike. So some lovely dahlias inside. Yeah.
We have Hannah Best saying, so beautiful. And what is the tall green plant? There's just one piece of it.
Yeah, well, actually there's more. But this is the only one that is still green. It is, let me see. This is the one. That's the whole thing. Well, this one is a little bit weak. Maybe I should show a better one. Yeah, yeah. This one. It's a Leonotis. Yeah. So let me put one in. Otherwise, he's so lonely. So now they're close together. Lovely. Could use some here. And maybe, because I still have them, one there. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, go ahead, Angelica.
We have Sally Gilchrist saying, love the pops of pink and orange.
Yeah, the colors come nicely together. Eh? I'm lucky with finding them in my garden. I was looking for, yes, this one. Because I like to repeat that. Oops, did not cut right. I like to repeat that a little bit more on the opposite side. Normally, I repeat the colors. But the only thing is that when you cut it, you don't want to show the whole of the stem. There. Well, we are very busy preparing for the master course and also for the master class. We have a master class by Niku in November. So we are very looking forward to that. And the master course, the 20 days master course with Gregor, starts on November 15th. So we're also working on that. Even kijken. That could be green. That could be pink. That's too close to that. Yep. Yep. So let it come out of the stones. And then of course, we are also working on our Christmas arrangements already, because we like to show some arrangements. And we have made it in blue and gold, but that's just a sample. Everybody with the workshops here at the school, everybody can choose their own color. So, like that. Yes, I forgot. No, I did not forget. I have some pumpkins, little ones. Just picking a hole. And then you have to look, Jacqueline, what you do. Yeah, thank you. There, little pumpkin. And then one more. Pin a hole. I put sticks in there. Do another one for Mike so he can catch it on camera. Push a hole, put a pin in. That's it. Simple as that. Let's see. probably there. Yeah. Yeah, go ahead, Angelica.
Yes, question from Jimmy. Are you at the school at the 3rd or 4th of November?
Oh, yes, yes, the 3rd and 4th of November. Then Nico is here, so he will give a masterclass. So please visit. I heard you're coming over for the Aalsmeer Flower Week. So please do. This might be a little bit more, could be a little bit more open there. That one is okay. No more holes. Yes, one more. One little hole.
So Jacqueline, Angela says, and your Christmas arrangements are so beautiful.
Oh, thank you very much. You haven't seen them yet. Well, of this year. Maybe you saw it. Yeah, of course you saw them before. But yeah, we are doing it a little bit different this year. Even kijken, I think that will be okay. Then I also cut something nice from the, what's the name of the garden? Well, the city garden. So I'm using a branch of the rose hips, and I like to have that one over my arrangement there, I think, or better there. Well, let's see. I'd like to have that orange together with that pink. So I'm going to wire it. Yep. And then cut the wire. Ja, tuurlijk. Of course. Yes, heavy stuff. Cut it. And I put the wire in the container so I don't lose it. And then where else can it be? There. Yeah, zeg het maar.
So Jimmy says, okay, perfect. Yes, coming over.
Okay, nice.
And Angela says, very inspiring.
Thank you. Thank you. So then it's no, I think I cut it too short. Yeah, for this place, but maybe, yeah, it will do on this place. Yeah, so I have a branch going over, and then later on I will thin out some more. Oh yeah, I put it on the container. I will take off some more branches of the, or leaves. So I thin them out, so my arrangement is still more visible. Yeah, something like that. Yeah, okay. So, where do you go? This was my first arrangement. I hope you enjoyed. Then we're going to... No, we're going to prepare for the second one. I have some, I love the Gloriosa. So I had them and then I have to use them. Otherwise Axel gets mad because I spilled money. Let's see, I have them in the middle. Then they could be... They don't really fit, but the colors fit very nicely because it's a little bit yellowish and pinkish. So I love those together with this. Yeah, and then it's done. Yeah. Yes, go ahead.
Yes, first of all, Angela said, well, that's why I like to study there. With
you.
A smiley face with
Thank
hearts.
You.
And a question from Angela. Do you bash the ends of the woody stems?
No, I never bash the ends of the wooden stems. That's a old-fashioned miscommunication or misunderstanding. But the way that you cut with a knife, that's the best way. So cut with a knife at an angle, then it will be perfectly fine. And if you have, for example, hydrangea, you can also use the dip, quick dip. You can use the quick dip if it's not hardy enough, but my hydrangea comes from my garden and it's already crispy, so it will stay for a long time. Even it probably will dry, so it will be fine. Yeah.
You can see the interview on our
YouTube. Yeah, that's a good one. Mike mentions that Peter Kolk from Kolk Hydrangeas, he says it's not necessary to do so. And you can go to our YouTube channel, if you're not already there. And there's an interview with Peter, and he's telling about that. So have a look on our website or on our YouTube channel.
Okay, so we have a few people saying some very nice things about your arrangement. Sally Hardy says, it's beautiful.
Thank you very much.
Jimmy says, me too, love Gloriosa. Sally Gilchrist says, very pretty. Hannah Best says, wonderful, it's fabulous, but got to go now, but we'll catch the other when the recording comes out. Bye,
yeah,
thank you.
You can also watch later, you can review it. So thank you very much. I will make another one. You can see that. You can see that later. But for who are you staying? If you are staying, when are you staying? Then please have a second, and then we'll prepare the other one. Because we need to do some rescheduling. Mag ik ook even een bezem? Oh. Is het geluid nog uit? Aan? Ja, yeah, but my mic dropped out of my...
Oh,
oeps. Ja. Nee, ik heb hem al erin. So, something like that. And then yeah, why do I always pick the heavy ones? Goh. Oh, ridiculous. Okay. So heavy. Can I please have the flowers a little bit closer? Can I get for the poot van het licht? Yep. Yeah, thank you. Well, it's a little bit disturbing in the frame, probably. Yeah. Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you well. I have some tifa. Well, in Holland we call it tifa. It's those cigars. Moet die nog verder naar achter? And some of them are protected, but this comes from somebody's garden, so these are not protected, I hope. And it's not the natural color. It looks a little bit like the natural color, but I sprayed them a little bit
burgundy.
With the burgundy color, the aqua color from Oasis. And I'm using an old pot that we already had. And I used a big block of Oasis. So an aqua, no, sorry, a Corso block. Long time ago that we had a Corso here, but we have a Corso block. They come in a box of like the size of like 20 in a box. But this one is 3 in a box. You can also have it in, you can also have one in a box. But that was really too big. And if you need big blocks, we sell them on our website. Axel will be so happy to ship them for you. Toch, Axel? Yeah, but he hears me. And I hear him. So, put them up straight, more or less. This is going to be a vegetative parallel arrangement with some bigger things than I'm used to. Well, and we make it also with the professional course and with the advanced course. But in this case, in this case, I use some bigger materials.
Axel just screamed, yes, I do.
I also have some beautiful gladiolus. Nice color. Do you see the mess I make here on the floor? No, that's good. And they're nice, also burgundy, wine red, a little bit. And I have two different ones, two different colors. One is even darker than the other. Also one behind. And I think if you still practice for the professional course, for example, then the gladiolus is also very beautiful if you use them single flowers, so one by one. Because then they look a little bit like little orchids. This is even darker, you see? It's almost black. Very nice.
That one is very pretty.
Yeah, mooi, hè? Very nice. Oh, this one still has the elastic band around it. Oops, don't go. It's always nice to make a bigger arrangement than we normally do in class. Little challenge. Then I also have some cotinas. Cotinas, they have like little wigs. When they, this one doesn't, but they can have a pruik, wig. Angelica bought a wig.
Yeah.
Some blonde ones or almost white.
Yeah, platinum blonde, long, curly.
For Halloween. For special occasions. Some on this side. This is also still on my wish list for the garden. And it also comes in a green. And then it has a darker wig. But this one has a lighter one. And then I also have some two of these. This is sorghum. It's also a kind of grain. And but this one is also from the garden. It has some little seeds in it, so you can eat them. They're very healthy. Let's see if my knife cuts them now. Yeah. Wil ik die zo of wil ik die zo? I think I want it like this. Do you have a question, Angelica?
Well, Ionella says, I wish all my days off to look like this one. Homeschooling, cooking, and relaxing with you.
Oh, thank you. Well, I think Angelica should make a recipe with pumpkins because we have plenty of pumpkins at the school at this moment.
A lot of pumpkins.
And I also have a... Yes.
Pumpkin pan.
Love it. And this one is broken, but I don't mind. Because that's also with a vegetative parallel. It can be a little bit broken because it's natural. Yeah, go ahead.
So first, Jimmy says, love the color, colors combo, dark red and purple.
Thank you.
A question from Angela.
Yeah.
Has Monty been yet?
Oh, no.
Still waiting.
No, still waiting and hoping. But no. But I need a gardener really, really soon. But Monty would be the most exquisite. I also use some... Mike?
Panicum.
Panicum, yeah, of course. I forgot that one again. Last time, I think, also. Nice dark color. That will give a little bit airy feeling inside. What is also nice is that we have some fruits and vegetables in the garden from the school. So I will use some grapes. Let me see, let me do that a little bit more behind.
Yeah, the fruits are doing very well this
year. Yeah, except for the cherries. The birds ate them all.
Yeah.
Yeah. Helaas. What is that daar? Het ziet er heel raar uit. Oh, that's probably my shirt. Yeah, yeah. So are there any questions? Not yet. Do we have something to talk about? Other than my arrangement while I'm working. Mike, can you please mention a name?
Mention a
topic.
Oh yeah, you were already starting to talk about it a little bit, but we have the master course with Gregor Lerch.
Yes.
Starting soon. And there's a couple of places available still.
Yes, we still have some. Yes, we the master course starts on November 15th, and we still have some spaces available. So if you want to join, please do so. It's 10 days in November and 10 days in March.
And what is the cost?
Oh, yes, the cost is for 20 days. It is 6,500 euros. And it's all including, all inclusive. So it's a Master Florist diploma. And it's all done by Gregor Lerch himself. So we are very lucky to have him here for 20 days. I was wondering if I could. Yes, the diploma has his signature. It has mine and it has his. Yes. So I think it's the highest level there is, because it's Gregor himself who's teaching it the whole time. So, and it will be very creative, very different than normal courses, very special. Yeah. Yeah, and it's a once in a lifetime experience. So, some more grapes from my garden. I think the leaves hang a little bit, but I don't mind in this case because it's autumn. And the birds already ate some of my grapes. Well, actually a lot of my grapes. Yeah.
So Anita says it's nice to see you work.
Thank you. Thank you.
And Ionella says love it. Love it. And a question from Sally Gilchrist.
Yes.
Is Halloween a big thing in the Netherlands?
That's a very good question. It's not that big in the Netherlands. It's getting bigger. But in our school, it's quite big. Because
it's
Angelica.
Huge.
Because Angelica loves Halloween. She likes to dress up and so on. So, yes. Yeah, we have something similar called Sint Maarten, but Sint Maarten is not dressed up like the Halloween.
Yeah, and it's only for like small children.
It's also for little children that go to the doors and then they have some candy. Yeah, but in this case, everybody's dressed up with Halloween, and in Holland it's not.
But there's a comparison. They sing for candy.
Yes, they sing for candy.
And instead of dressing up, they make their own lanterns.
Yeah. Or buy them nowadays. Yes, they make their own lanterns, and they also sing for candy. That's correct, but it's not not everywhere, and in the south of Holland it is not there on the November 11th, but it's on in December.
Yeah.
Yes, a lot. Yes. In the south of Holland, we have carnival, and then we do dress up.
But it's not the same as Halloween. It's not scary.
No, it's not scary. No.
Halloween is more fun.
Yeah, you like the scary part, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What is carnival about? It's about also about spirits, isn't it?
Yes. Okay. It's also about spirits, but it's also before everybody needs to be decent, and also it's a big party before you do sober things. So
Vasten.
Yeah, it's like
fasting.
It's almost like fasting. It's a little bit more,
but then completely the other way around, because you're with carnival, you drink, you dance.
Yeah, but that's you party
and
before.
And then you,
you do the
fasting after that.
Yes.
In the past, people would do it for religious reasons, fasting afterwards, but now nobody's fasting anymore. Yeah. Just party.
Yeah. So next year, hopefully, we can party again. Correct. Oh, yes, I still had some apples.
And there's a question from Jimmy.
Yeah.
Which style do you love to work with the most?
Oh, I love Dutch gardens. I love Dutch gardens. And also, I love to work big. Like crazy things. Like the big hat that I made once for at Fleur Amour. In a room, and it's full, so it's full. They fall. It was a hat the size of a table at that time.
Yeah, that was great.
Yeah, that was nice. With a lot of chrysanthemums from Dekker Chrysanthemums and a lot of summer flowers from summerflowers.nl. Beautiful, beautiful stuff we had. Yeah.
Mike, this one is for you. Angela says, ask Mike to look at his DM on Instagram. So he will. And Sally Gilchrist says, very interesting, and thank you for the information about Halloween and all our other festive funness. And Lindley McFarland says, what are the rules for this style of design?
Oh, that's a good question. That's a good question. I think for the rules are that you don't have too much on the top. Still a little bit see-through, and I layered them. So I have the Tifa, the cigars I have in the top, then I have a layer of the grasses, and then a layer of the cotinas, and then a layer of the sedum. And they mix, so they alternate a little bit, but they're not all in the top. Go ahead.
So Jimmy says, yes, did thinking about the dahlia for that arrangement.
Yes, it's a beautiful color, eh, for that. Then I also have some cabbage. Not edible, I think, this one. And it's a little bit wet because it came from outside.
So, question from Angela.
Yeah.
What is a typical Dutch garden design?
A typical Dutch garden design? Oh, please look on our YouTube channel. We have several Dutch gardens in on the live streams, and also we have on our Facebook page and on Instagram we also have Dutch gardens, but most of the time there is a high and low level and the heights are not touching each other. And then with a lot of natural things, so like the conifers, the grasses. We also have some color and some flowers with it, but it doesn't have to be too much. Then also I'd like to add a little bit of, where is it? Too far behind. A little bit of orange. A little touch, so you get some depth in it. And some brightness at the base. And I thought I had used all the soil beforehand, but now my hands are still a little bit dirty. So, some carthamus in between. Oh, and one more apple. One more apple. Where is that one going? There. I probably could use an apple there. Zou een van jullie twee alvast die spullen van de tafel af willen halen? Dan kunnen zo meteen dat kerststuk naar binnen. So I have also probably, yes, some more sedum. And I've used the soil in here, but I don't mind that I see it because I think it looks quite natural and I think it should be in there. So I'm not, I don't mind that I see some soil sometimes. Ik heb alleen nog een klein beetje platmos nodig. Het is in de draadstandaard. Ja, thank you very much. There is some flat moss. I don't like to use the bulb moss for this, but I like to use the flat moss because the flat moss is easy to cover the oasis. And also, yeah, it's flat. It doesn't need to be round in this case because I want to have it on the same height as the container. That's why I used my oasis lower than my container. Yeah, go ahead.
Yes, Joyce Shabby Chic says nature gives us so much treasures, especially in the autumn. I love your design, Jacqueline. But don't the tifa lose their fluffiness?
Yes, but I spray painted them. So in this case, they're all stuck. The ones that I did not spray, I put them outside immediately because they were losing their fluffs all over the school. So yeah, you're right. They lose them quite quickly. So in this case, I spray painted them. So I like it's like hairspray and it doesn't lose then. Okay, and I think then this one is done. Thank you very much for watching this arrangement.
We have more to show.
And we have much more to show, so please hold on a second, because we have to change the scenery again. Staat er nog ergens een bezem? That's a funny sight. Here you go. Well, misschien maar even de eerste bezem er doorheen. Nee, doe dat nog eventjes. Because it needs to go a little bit more to the front. So the people, dat kan weg. Yep. Here we go then. Tidum, 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 tidum,
tidum, tidum. Angela and Sally Gilchrist are giving you a applause.
Thank you. Here you go.
Sally Hardy also giving a applause.
Okay, so here we are. This is our arrangement, well, two of our arrangements for this Christmas. In this case, we made it in gold and blue. And what is very popular in Holland, you never know. It's the Delft blue. So the Delft blue can also be used in here. But of course, the students can pick their own color. And we do this one in an oval shape. This is a classic arrangement for the workshop. Volgens mij hangt die te ver naar links.
Ja, ik kom goed.
Okay. So this one is the classical arrangement. And we also make these candle holders ourselves. During the lesson, and it's a 2.5 hours course. Nothing broken. So that's the one. It's oval shape. Ta-dam. So you can see it like that. There, that's one. And then we have the Christmas tree arrangement. The Christmas tree arrangement is a little bit on a boat. Zal ik deze eraf halen? Deze weg? Oh, my lights went off. I had some lights in there. Let's see. Yes, it's on. So, this is a Christmas tree that we like to do during our Christmas courses. And it's made with Oasis bricks. And I grouped the materials. And of course, the other arrangement, the classic one, you can also group. So it's a little bit more modern style. And this is oval shape. Normally we make it cone shape, Christmas tree shape. But this one is a flat arrangement. So that's the one. And then we also have another arrangement. That's the hanging object arrangement. And we made that with branches and some pine cones hanging down. And some very nice branches of the the schijnbeuk. Fagus,
Notofagus.
Notofagus, that's the one. Of course, this is in blue and gold, but it can be also made in any color that the students like.
So they are online on our website.
You can register for that if you like. And the Saturday is already fully booked. So the other ones, we still have some spaces available, but for the Saturday, it's fully booked. So here with, I have maybe some questions.
Well, Jimmy says great work with
Thank you, Jimmy.
Muscle power.
Yeah, Dutch people there. Thank you.
But for now, no questions.
Then we are going to say goodbye. That was it for today. In 14 days, we are back again. If you have liked this live stream, please click the like button and subscribe and join us here live next time, hopefully in a couple of weeks. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye. Ha, ha, ha.